everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. Here we've got a couple of big targets who will try to be key contributors in both the pass and run games today. It's the Dolphins going up against the Bills. With that, let's send you up to Orchard Park in Western New York, where we say hello to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
From the home of the Bills since 1973, there's a look at Ralph Wilson Stadium just outside of Buffalo, New York. Today, we've got an AFC East matchup between the Miami Dolphins and the Buffalo Bills. Hi again, everybody. Alongside my partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we saw Larry focus on the tight end matchup in his open. You think it's one to watch, don't you?
Definitely one to watch, because these guys can create such big plays by all the different things they can do. Line up out wide, in the slot, line up in a normal tight end position, and then who are you going to cover them with? Is it a linebacker, a defensive back? They create mismatches all throughout the game.
Getting ready is the kicker, Andrew Franks. And off we go from Ralph Wilson Stadium. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And last year, that would have been a net gain of 5 on the return. This year, he stopped where he would have been if he had taken a knee. And that's at the 25. So here come the Bills on offense for the first time. They're led out by their mobile quarterback, the 6-year man. It's Tyrod Taylor.
I've always loved Tyrod Taylor's mobility. I love his footwork, his ability to escape, but his underrated arm. Accurate, downfield throwing, that's what I really like about his game.
Now Taylor on first down, and the open receiver, it's Robert Woods. It'll be a gain of 9, and it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first. A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there, because the confidence elevates.
Here's the first carry for LeSean McCoy. A beautiful fake. And he's brought down. They give him 17 yards that time, as that'll move the chains. So McCoy adding to his yardage total in this one. Last year, 895 yards in his first season in Buffalo. Of course, he had, Charles, 4,000-yard years in Philadelphia.
And you know the man they call Shady wants to throw some shade at the Eagles for ever letting him go. He wants a big year in 2016.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group.
Flex round! Flex round!
And they'll keep on the ground with McCoy. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends, because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
Come on, let's go!
On 2nd down, Taylor. And incomplete. Robert Woods, former USC man, the intended target. And that'll bring up a 3rd down. Here's the offensive unit, and heads up, look out for the Clemson Tiger.
Sammy Watkins was brought in to make plays. That's what he specializes in, out on the perimeter or going inside.
And they'll need the 39 here for a first. This is 3rd down. Yeah, the Dolphins beef up the secondary here as they look to stop him on 3rd down. From the shotgun, it's Taylor. surveying the field. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it. Trying to get those rack yards before he secured it.
So on fourth down, the Bills call on the punt unit and Colton Schmidt. And this is going to be ruled out, I think, just inside the 20. Yes, it will. Side judge calls it at the 19-yard line. So here come the Dolphins now as they get set to take over on offense. They're led out by their strong-arm quarterback out of Texas A&M. It's Ryan Tannehill.
I think one of the things I like about Ryan Tannehill's game is that he understands what his receivers are looking for downfield. He played that position at Texas A&M before becoming the starting quarterback. So a lot of times when he's in the pocket looking downfield, he's actually running the routes with the receivers as he remembers them.
Get across the 20, but only to about the 22-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. The wide receivers, often a very, very talented group, and that's the case here.
And they don't mind showcasing it either. Those guys love to be flashy, love to make big plays out in the open field. They will attempt to do so in this game.
Here we go with second and 7. They'll run it now out of the gun. That's going to be a 6-yard gain. It leaves them with third down and just a yard to go.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position now more than ever is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
Tannehill going to throw on third and 1. Hard throw, incomplete. His tight end Jordan Cameron, the intended target. And that's going to bring up a fourth down.
On third and 1, I think everyone in the stadium thought they'd try and run the football there, but they tried to surprise the defense and hit something through the air. Instead, it results in an incompletion.
So on fourth down, the Dolphins will ask Matt Darr to kick it away. He'll look to set up his blockers. That'll be a 50-yard punt with 8 on the return. And the Bills will take over the football with a 1st and 10. And now out come the Bills. And they'll be looking to avoid what happened last time, which is punting the football.
Here we go.
But when you look at how teams play the game, that complimentary football comes into play. How do I take care of my defense? How do I take care of my offense? Well, the defense is taking care of them in a lot of ways. Now it's time for the offense to jump things up and help their defense out. Give them a little bit of rest.
Yeah, it's time for them to give them a rest. You took the words right out of my mouth. And let's run through the Dolphins' defense.
Mario Williams broke into the league as a star defensive end. Now he's wreaking havoc as an outside linebacker.
It's McCoy, and McCoy loses the football, and this is picked up by the Dolphins, and his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
And the Dolphins getting set to go here. And a three and out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive?
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go.
Second down here after the incomplete pass. Now Tannehill. Oh, battle at the line and enter. Does the big boy have the juice? A great read and it's picked off. And they will finally run him down, but not until he brings this one all the way back down inside the 10-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
Getting set to go. And a fumble last time. Ball security. Talk about it all the time in the National Football League. They've got to be better at it on this drive.
Don't you think that when every team gets together for the first time, I don't care if it's OTAs, mini camps, first day of camp in the regular season, ball security comes up about what, the second sentence of the coach's address?
And those are so many drills focus on that.
All the time, and they do drills to make it even tougher to simulate game situations. Doesn't always work out, though.
Now the Dolphins are going to halt the action here. It's a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. All right, so the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense.
Here we go! Grand 38! Grand 38!
They'll try again with McCoy. Shreds the tackle and give him 2 yards officially, and now it'll be third and goal. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being four down territory.
Defense may be thinking pass. They come out in the nickel on third and goal. They'll try and run it with McCoy. What a stand so far defensively, and now that's going to bring up a fourth and goal.
Now, this feels like old-school football because this has turned into a good old-fashioned goal line stand. So on offense, what do you do now? Do you decide to run it or throw it if you go for it on fourth down?
So on fourth down, here comes the field goal unit for the Bills, led by Dan Carpenter. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle. And Carpenter knocks it through, and the Bills will take a 3-0 lead. So they recover the fumble but could not take advantage of the short field. They do get three.
And no one ever turns down 3 points going up on the board, but the offense will go to the sidelines wondering what if, while the defense on the other side, they'll celebrate holding them to just a field goal after giving up such bad field position.
Carpenter Carpenter now after the made field goal will kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. Oh, nice move. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Now out of the gun, and he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. So just a lone field goal in this first quarter of play. 3-0 is our score, and we're back to upstate New York after this.
NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Head & Shoulders. Shoulders were made for greatness, not dandruff.
Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter begins with the Dolphins in possession of the football. They've got it second and 10 to start things out. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Here's Tannehill now on second down. And Cameron has it over the middle. And he got blown up on that play. Back at the 20. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage lost, though. Huh?
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off. The Bills bring out a couple of extra defensive backs to defend this third down play.
Yeah, they're going dime. A shotgun snap for Tannehill. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. It's the rookie from Ohio State, Adolphus Washington. In there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that'll lead to a fourth down.
Well, how about that? A dime set on defense, 6 defensive backs. None of them blitz. They're just back there in coverage. Defensive lineman gets the sack.
That's where the O-line, they go to the sideline, they keep their helmets on so the cameras can't find them, right?
Yeah, the cameras can't find them, but I know one thing. The O-line coach will.
Here's Matt Darr now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. That's taken on the 25. Great blocking on the return. It springs him for 25. And this offense takes over in great shape right at the 50, first and 10. Onto the field now comes the Bills offense. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But let's have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done. That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Fresh set of downs here. Now Taylor going to hand this one off to McCoy. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Fake to McCoy. Now it's Taylor. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down. They got to get to the 23 here on third.
And they insert their dime package, six DBs here on third and six.
Expecting pass all the way. Now it's Taylor. He's got time in the pocket. Going to drop this off to McCoy, complete. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
In the red zone this time.
Come on, let's go! Red 38!
From the red zone now, here's Taylor on first down. And this is caught at the 8. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up first and goal.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
To throw again is Taylor. That's caught at the 1. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Leonard Hankerson, a 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Bills will add on to their lead. And that score gives them a little more separation and a bigger lead.
A little more of a comfort zone now. They can do more things defensively, maybe take a few more gambles as they try to continue to extend their lead.
Dan Carpenter now for the extra point. It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. After the TD, here's Carpenter on to kick it away. Here comes Grant on the return. Oh, what a move. And he breaks it all the way out to the 38-yard line. Great return. So now here come the Dolphins. And still no points on the scoreboard. You're coming off of the 3-and-out. They're just looking for anything to grab onto right now, aren't they?
I'm wondering if someone's going to take charge in the huddle. You know, we always look to the quarterback, but sometimes it's another player on the team, a star, a veteran, someone with some excitement and energy. It's like, all right, guys, let's shake things up and let's go, because they still have an opportunity to make things happen.
Shake it off.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
Game clock at 2:01. Time for one final play before the 2-minute warning. Second and 10. Tannehill once more. Finding time. This is caught. The tight end Cameron. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. So 1:55 to go in the first half. Back to Buffalo after this. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Larry Ridley is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. And now a first down following that long gain. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. On first down, it's Tannehill. To the right side, and he's got Landry complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. Red zone opportunity.
Ready, wide 20, wide 20. Dagger, dagger. Dagger, dagger. Zebra, zebra, zebra.
From the red zone now, Tannehill. And this is caught by Parker for a Miami touchdown. Devontae Parker from 17 yards out. And the Dolphins able to get this back within a touchdown.
Sometimes when I see these types of plays executed, I think of basketball. Guys boxing other guys off to go out and get a rebound.
And he got the rebound right there. But the defense was really placed well.
Yeah, they were right there. I mean, that's where it's really tough for a defender. When you're in the right spot, you're draped on the guy catching the ball, yet he still comes down with it.
Now Andrew Franks on for the point after. And they're back within a field goal. It's 10-7 now. Franks now on to kick it away after the touchdown. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Offense comes out ready to take over, and they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counterpunch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive.
Let's go.
Now Taylor to throw on second down. He's got time. And that one got tipped. Kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
So much of this game is about leverage. We always talk about low man wins in the trenches. Well, it's like that in just about every position. And sometimes, if you lose that leverage and you're losing the battle, just jump up at the line of scrimmage and try and bat the ball away. And that's exactly what happened there.
And ready for third and six. Watkins alone on the left side.
Here we go.
On third down, Taylor. And this is caught by Watkins. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. So the offense has it first and 10.
Let's go! Grand 38! Grand 38!
Again, it's Taylor. Looking for his tight end, Clay, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Koamisi. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
Offensively, when you see cover two, the thought has to go through the quarterback's head. Drive the football when making throws. It's not just the deep guys covering. It's the guys underneath you have to be careful of. Drive your throw. Otherwise, you see what results? Interceptions.
The Dolphins offense now working their way back onto the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of...
And they take him down. The Bills get to him. Adolphus Washington in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback, because he had no chance to block him.
And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Here's Tannehill. On the left side, this is Stills. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. It'll be a pickup of 12 yards. And just like that, it's third down. So the offense takes the timeout, and they are back out and ready to rock. They'll need to get it to the 30 for a first. This is third down. Defense thinking pass. They've got the nickel set out on 3rd and 6. Throwing on third down, Tannehill. And he's got his man, that's Landry. It goes as a gain of 6, and it's a first down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. The final shot here before the break, Tannehill. Looking deep for his tight end, Cameron. And they can't get the long connection as it falls incomplete. So we've hit halftime, just a field goal separating these two teams at the break. As we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
All right, let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Third and long, Washington's going to take down the QB here. This will go as a loss of 5. About halfway through the second quarter, Hankerson's got the reception, and it ends up working for a touchdown, pushing the lead to 10. Now first and 10, Tannehill's got the completion out of the gun, and this 4-play drive goes for a touchdown. Dolphins now down by just 3. Offense out now following the turnover. Washington's going to push his way to the QB here. This will go for a loss of 7. So that'll do it for us. We'll go back now to Orchard Park for the second half.
Thank you, sir. A field goal separates these two teams as we come back for this second half. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Second down following the run. A shotgun snap for Tannehill. And he'll lay out and pull it in. What a diving catch there. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar.
Circle the Pro Bowl?
Without a doubt. That's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. And it's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
Ready, blue 10.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Out of the gun, Tannehill. And Stills over the middle. And he's brought down. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. On first and 10, Tannehill throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. Jordan Cameron is tied in the intended receiver, and that'll make it second and 10.
The defensive coordinator came into this game with a plan to get to the quarterback with whatever type of pressure is necessary. It's working to perfection for him today.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10.
Set 380. Set.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And there's a flag on the play. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Got the hand caught up in the grill of the face mask, 15-yard penalty.
So tough for a defender. You're trying so hard to make a play, and the way that these offensive guys can move around, sometimes your hand gets into the wrong place.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Now a first down throw, Tannehill to the right side, and he's got Landry complete. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Now that was well defended, and as a cornerback, what you're taught when you see a wide receiver screen, either you get underneath the play before the blocking forms, or you're going to have to fight your way through it by getting through some blocking. That was a really nice play there.
It's a five receiver set. Three to the left, two to the right. Again, Tannehill. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down.
Third and 11, five in the secondary now.
Nickel look. To the air again, Tannehill. And it's caught by Parker. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. So he makes the grab and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line giving them time to complete that first down pass.
And now the offense operates in the red zone. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. He'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a 2nd and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
On 2nd down, here's Tannehill. He's got it. Touchdown, Dolphins. Devontae Parker, his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Dolphins are in for 6.
I know we often laugh, and sometimes we even exalt the guys who are great trash talkers and give us some really funny lines. But the bottom line is absolute production on the field. His 2nd touchdown of the game, and they lead.
And now they'll be looking to their defense to preserve that lead. Franks to add the PAT. And that makes it 14-10. Franks now on to kick it away after the touchdown. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. Start the drive with a carry by McCoy. And he'll be brought down here at the 28. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. One man on the backfield. That's McCoy. Here's Taylor. And that's caught left side. It's Woods. It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs. So here we go, 1st and 10 now. They'll come out in the pistol. They go play action here on 1st down. He's going to let this one go deep. A 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. Picked by the rookie, Xavien Howard. And they will set up shop at their own 41-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they're throwing an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight. We have played three quarters. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Buffalo. It's Dolphin football. It's also Dolphin lead to begin quarter number four. Second down following the run. They'll come out in the pistol. Here's Tannehill now on second down. It's caught. Cameron, left side. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that'll bring up a third and one.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Third down now following the completed pass. And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45.
Third and one, partner. No need to be fancy there. Just use some force and move forward and pick up the first down.
The offense lining up first and 10. Now they try the right side here. Oh, no, he lost the football. But I think a Dolphin was able to fall on it. Yes, they'll keep possession here. So now a first and 20. Now a play fake here on first down. And he's got his man on the crossing route. That's Landry. They got 29 yards there. And the Dolphins have a first down. And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
Takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver, because you've got to read those zones and where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone, sometimes you're throwing it between the zones, sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when they're in sync, it's really effective.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Now it's Tannehill off the bootleg. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Jerry Hughes in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
So what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
To throw on second down is Tannehill. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. They'll give him a yard on the play. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game. Extra DB on the field for the Bills here on third down.
Yeah, maybe thinking pass. Now Tannehill. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. It'll come from the right hash. It's a 47-yard attempt. And Frank's kick is good. And that moves him up by a touchdown now at 17-10. So, Charles, I think from a defensive perspective, you have to look at that field goal there and consider it a win.
You were able to keep him within a touchdown, so no question about it. That was the kind of stand that keeps you in ball games.
Now it's Franks following the made field goal to send it away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And, of course, the quarterback in this situation, he's realizing time is becoming a factor. Let's see if they can get some points on the board here late.
Let's go!
They go back to the air here after the INT. He's got time in the pocket, and he'll check this one down to McCoy.
Holding, defense.
So the grab there by the defense, the holding penalty call. Leading here late, so a chance for the defense to really close out this game if they can halt the offense.
Let's go! Brad 38!
Now Taylor on first down. And that will be caught, but out of bounds. Out of bounds, ruled incomplete here.
That was a nice catch, but unable to stay in bounds. And remember, it wasn't a wide receiver who works on that all the time.
I was going to say, he likes to get the ball handed to him. Now, don't get me wrong, he's part of the passing game as well, but maybe a little out of his comfort zone there.
Yeah, he might want to have a few words to say to us about that later, but I am still going with you on that one. Wide receivers work on a little bit more.
Again, we'll see the pistol here. Again, now it's Taylor on second and 10. Man open right side. It's the tight end Clay. It's a gain of 5, and it'll be third down.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
Yeah, interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. So here we go. A third down after the second down pass completion. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. So it's Bills football here as we get you reset. They face a critical third down now, needing a score here in the late going. Around 2 minutes to go, and if the D can hold them, that'll end this one.
We always think about the offense attacking. In this case, I'm looking for the defense to do the same.
From the gun on third down, it's Taylor. Finding time. He's going to let it fly. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's gonna hurt.
And this will be taken at the 13. So possession goes over here on the punt, and it'll be Dolphin football. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. So a defensive timeout, chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is good. Now the Bills will take another timeout. That'll be their 2nd, so one more chance to stop the clock here. And we'll be back. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. Defense has set themselves up nicely. 3rd and 10 now.
Ace, dagger. Ready, 3-8.
Now it's Tannehill. He shakes him off. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Normally he's pretty reliable. Usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
Here's Matt Darr now, as he's on to punt for Miami. And a great job here. This is going to turn out to be a beauty. This is marked down at about the 3-yard line. The Dolphins defense, they get set to go here. And they have been so strong all game long, they just need to show up here one final time, Charles.
And this isn't a spot where they're going to run out onto the field and look at each other and say, okay, can we hold on? They've been strong all game, as you talked about.
Yes, you got some confidence.
Confidence? They're thinking, let's just go out there and shut them down 1, 2, 3 and get out of here. That's how they feel right now.
They'll start on the ground with McCoy. And he's going to lose yardage back to his own 1-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd down. And now they're in the hurry up. Back to throw. Pass incomplete. We've got a 3rd and 11. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look
Let's
defensively.
Go.
He'll look to throw. He's got time. And this is going to be incomplete. Sammy Watkins, the intended target, and that'll bring up 4th down.
That's a really fine play there, because anytime you see a comeback route, that means you cannot just stay in one spot and make a play on the ball. You've got to move your feet and move with the receiver, and that's exactly what he did.
Down seven, and they've got to go for it here on fourth down.
Come on, let's go! What? 90!
Here we go. It's Taylor on fourth down. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And how about this for a setup? The ball will go over on downs at the one-yard line. Well, they've got the slim deficit, decided to go for it, hoping to keep the football score and erase that deficit. But, boy, deep in their own territory like that?
Let's just say that with that call, me and the head coach will agree to disagree. All right, but he knew he wanted to be aggressive there, as you pointed out. So I guarantee he told his defensive coordinator, have your guys up and ready. I'm going to go for it here. If we don't get it, just make sure they're ready to go out there and bail us out.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you've got to feel good about your chances.
Now Franks for the extra point. And the lead is up to 14. Franks now on to kick it away after the touchdown. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now the Bills' offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. And Charles, in this situation, this is where the word miracle comes into play.
Have to score real fast, maybe throw a jump ball in the end zone and hope for the best.
Second and 10, it's Taylor again. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. It'll be a gain of 6, and they're going to have a third down.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together, when the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. From the shotgun, it's Taylor. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. And no, it's incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Dolphins get the football in great field position. So with that, we can just about close the book on this one, Charles.
Yeah, what's the old expression about Slim and none? Well, Slim just left town on that
They're
one.
They're down to none?
Yes, exactly right.
Out comes the Dolphin offense now as they get set to take over here. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter.
Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. It'll be their third and final timeout. So as they talk things over, we'll step aside. Yards left for the offense. It's second down.
Dagger.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Call it a gain of four there, so it sets up a big play here. Third and a yard.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
So third down, just 1 yard to go.
Set 380. 380.
And you know, winning is good for all the obvious reasons, but if for nothing else, it makes tomorrow's film session a little more palatable, doesn't it?
Oh, indeed it does. Sometimes it helps you in the grading because the coaches will look at it, and if it's a borderline play for you, if you won the game, you might get a plus in your column instead of a minus.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaunt. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. With that, we say so long from Buffalo.